evaluate each expression. So to evaluate these expressions, we now need to append our order of operations agreement because we've added a piece. We've added dealing with exponents. So first, we now will evaluate any exponents in each term. Working from left to right. Then we will evaluate all multiplications and additions inside of each term. Again, working from left to right. And then finally, we will add and subtract the terms. Again, working from left to right. Okay, so let's keep that in mind. So again, it's important to understand what the terms are. Remember that the terms are the parts of the expression separated by additions or subtractions. So in this first expression, 20 plus 3 to the second power, I see two terms. I see the 20 and I see the 3 to the second. I'm going to deal with that exponent first. So this would be 20 plus 9, and now I can add 29. Going on to exercise B, I see three terms. I see 4, 60 divided by 5, and 3 square. Evaluating the exponent first, 4 plus 60 divided by 5 minus 9. So there are no further exponents. Now I'm going to evaluate any multiplications or divisions within terms. So I have a division here. I have the 60 divided by 5, which is 12, so I now have 4 plus 12 minus 9. And now I'll add and subtract as I see them from left to right. 4 plus 12 is 16, and 16 minus 9 is 7. Five cubed divided by 10, subtract negative 4. There are only two terms in this expression. 5 cubed divided by 10 is a single term, and then we have the subtraction of negative 4. So within that first term, the 5 cubed divided by 10, the exponent takes precedence. 5 cubed means 5 times 5 times 5, so that's 125. So I have 125 divided by 10, subtract negative 4. Now there's still two terms, so I have to deal with that division first. Now 125 divided by 10, we can either write that as a fraction or a decimal. I'm going to go ahead and use a decimal form here. 125 divided by 10 is 12.5, subtract negative 4. And now subtraction is addition of the opposite, so that's 12.5, add positive 4, which is 16.5.